Hi guys, welcome back. Today's topic of discussion is the levels of organization. That we'll start from the basic level and then we'll move on to the highest level in which the organisms are being organized. Okay, so the basic level that we'll be starting with is the subatomic and atomic level. The first thing that we'll be discussing is what does matter made up of? Matter itself is made up of elements. These elements are made up of atoms, and atoms are made up of subatomic particles. Atom is the smallest level. Now, what is the meaning of atom? Wherever, remember, if A is associated with any scientific word, that means not. Mostly that means not. And in this case, Tom means cut. Anything that cannot be cut. Therefore, atom, the meaning of atom is something that cannot be cut. So this is an atom which makes up elements. Now, these atoms consist of subatomic particles. The particles that are present within the atom. This is the picture of an atom. It consists of three particles, protons, these red ones, electrons, which are present in the orbits, and neutron, that is also present within the nucleus. These are the three subatomic particles which combine to form an atom. Now, this atom, it combines to form elements. We have already discussed it. There are about 92 total elements. But we are studying about biology, so we are going to discuss the elements that are forming the living organisms. And those are about 16 and are known as bioelements, which make up the living organisms. So about 16 bioelements are present in the out of these 16, six of them makes up the 99% of the body mass. Those six are oxygen, about 65%, carbon, 18%, hydrogen, 10%, nitrogen is 3%, calcium is 2%, phosphorus 1%, and there are about 10 of these traces elements which makes up about the 1% of the remaining body mass. These are potassium, sulfur, chlorine, sodium, magnesium, Fe stands for iron, copper, manganese, zinc, and iodine. So these are the total 16 bioelements, which are further divided into 6 major elements and 10 traces bioelements. They make up the complete body of a living organism. This is how they are divided. This was the first level of organization, that is subatomic and atomic level. From this level, we'll move on to the next level, that is the molecular level. This is the molecular level. Now, molecular level, when you're talking about molecular level, obviously we'll be dealing with the bioelements. I already told you, we are starting from the lowest level to the highest level, right? So, the bioelements, they are of the nature that they cannot be present in the isolated form. They are not stable in that form. So, they look for certain bonding. And those bonds are formed in the form of ionic and covalent bond, right? These elements will combine with each other and then they will form molecules which are known as biomolecules. They will combine with the help of the ionic and covalent bond and then they will result in the formation of the biomolecule. And what are biomolecules? These are building blocks of living organisms. Million of bioelements are present within the living organism that make up the body of the living organism. There are a number of different types, right? So biomolecules are the building block. They're divided into two types. Those two types are micromolecules and macromolecules. The name is indicating micro, smaller, those with the lower molecular weight. For example, glucose, water, these are the example of micromolecules. Whereas macromolecules, macro meaning large, and macromolecules, those with the high molecular weight. For example, these proteins, carbohydrates, lipids, nucleic acid, these are all the macromolecules. So these are the two major type of the biomolecules, which are micromolecules and the macromolecule. And this is the second level, which is known as molecular level. And bioelements combine through ionic and covalent bond, and they result in the formation of the biomolecules. Now comes the third level, that is the organelle and cell level. Organelle and cell level. We have studied about biomolecules. Now, biomolecules, they combine together to form different type of organelles. Now, what are organelles? These are subcellular structures which are present inside the nucleus. Nucleus ke andar jo structures present hote hain, those are known as subcellular structures or organelles. For example, these are Golgi apparatus, mitochondria, endoplasmic reticulum. These are different organelles present within the cell. So these organelles combine to form a cell. Every single organelle have a particular function. For example, if we talk about mitochondria. Mitochondria is the powerhouse of cell. What do you mean by powerhouse? Something that is providing energy. Okay? So the energy that is required for different metabolism or different processes that has to occur in the human body, that is provided by mitochondria. That is its function. Similarly, ribosomes, it is responsible for protein synthesis, synthesis of protein in our body. Uske andar role play karta hai hamare paas ribosomes. There is a division of labor. When we talk about a cell, there is a division of labor. And what do you mean by division of labor? That labor has been divided between different organelles. Every single organelle will perform its own function, will give its own role, and thus it will contribute towards the complete function of a cell. So there is a complete division of labor among different organelles. Every single organelle will perform their own function, and then it will complete they will combine and will form a complete cell. Ek pura cell hamare paas banta. Now, when we talk about cell, agar hum log cell ki baat karein, cell are of two types, prokaryotes and eukaryotes. We'll discuss it in detail in the next videos, but I'll give you a brief overview. What are prokaryotes and what are eukaryotes? These are unicellular, meaning only one cell is present between them. These are unicellular organisms, and no membrane bounded organelles are present in it. Okay? Whereas eukaryotes, they can be unicellular, or multicellular, but the difference is the organized structures are present in the eukaryotic cells. Multicellular, number of millions of cells are combined to form a complete individual, and every single cell will have a particular function to perform, and all the organelles will be membrane bound. This is the major difference between the prokaryotes and eukaryotes. Clear? So this is how cell is divided into two types. Those are prokaryote or prokaryotic cell and eukaryotes or eukaryotic cell. So this was the third level, that was the organelle and the cell level. After the organelle and cell level, we will move on towards the other level, that is the tissue level. Okay, that is tissue level. Now we have just talked about cell. Similar cell, they will combine to perform a similar function. When similar type of cell performing a similar function, they group together, they will form a tissue. Every single tissue that is present in our body will perform a different function. There are a number of tissues that are present in our body, in a body of a living organism, right? But you need to remember, every single cell that is present within a tissue, individually it will be performing its own function. Apna function bhi wo individually perform kar sakta hai. Meaning, cell ke andar jo ribosomes hain, they will be responsible for protein synthesis. Whereas mitochondria energy produce karega, right? It will produce energy. Similarly, all other organelles will be performing their own function within the cell. But these cells combine together and will perform the function of tissue as well. Iska kya matlab hai? There are two types of tissues, animal tissues, major two types, and plant tissues, right? Animal tissues and plant tissues. Now, animal tissues, number of tissues are there. I'll give you a few examples like these that have been given in the diagram. Epithelial tissues that are present on the skin, on the upper part of the skin. Connective tissues, the name is indicating they connect different tissues. Muscles tissues make up our muscles. Nervous tissues responsible for giving signals. These are the type of the animal tissues. Similarly, in case of plant tissues, epidermal tissues that are responsible for the formation of the upper layer in the plants. Xylem tissues responsible for the transport of water. Phloem tissues responsible for the transport of food. These are the different type of tissues that are present in the living organisms. So this is the fourth level, in which similar cells performing a similar function, they will group together and will form a tissue. Or then that tissue will perform its own particular function. Today we'll be discussing these four level of organization. I will complete the level of organization in the next video. I will just summarize it. It started from the basic level is the atomic and subatomic level. Atoms combine to form elements, whereas atom itself is made up of subatomic particles that are electron, proton and neutrons. And there are about 92 elements, 16 of them are bioelements, and out of those 16, 6 major make up the 99% of the body mass, and other 10 are traces. These are present in the traces amount. Then bioelements combine to form biomolecules, which are of two types, micromolecules and macromolecules. The name is indicating micro with low molecular weight, macro with high molecular weight. Their sizes are larger as compared to micromolecules. Then these biomolecules combine to form organelles, and organelles combine to form a cell. And then similar cell will combine to form a particular tissue that will be performing a particular function. And these are of two types, animal tissues and plant tissues. And they will perform their own functions, and there are number of types of the animal tissues and number of type of the plant tissue. So this concludes our lesson, and I hope everything is clear. If you've got any confusion, let me know in the comment section. And if you've got any other suggestion, let me know that as well. And thank you so much for joining. Till next time, stay safe. Bye-bye.